Hello all, in this video I'll talk about Jakarta platform features. So let's start talk with recording enhancement done in Jakarta release. Go in left navigator, click on create new. It's a new feature which has been introduced in Jakarta release. By clicking on this link, we can navigate to new report designer UI. It's the report designer UI which has been introduced in Jakarta release. If you want to navigate to older version of report creation UI, then you can click on this switch to classic UI link. Now you see how we can create report from Excel document. This is also a new feature which has been introduced in Jakarta. So for this, Performance Analytics Premium plugin should be installed in your instance. So you will see one more type has been added in a drop down, which is external import. It will come only when this plugin is installed in the ServiceNow instance. Click on this icon to upload a file. This is the Excel sheet which I have uploaded, and this Excel sheet contains this data. Give name to this file as demo and set the expiration as 2 weeks. After this time period, this file will be deleted, as well as this report will no longer be available in the system. Here you can set the visibility. For now, I'm just setting the visibility as only me here. Click on this upload button. This is the way you can create report by importing Excel sheet in ServiceNow instance. Click on next button. If you want to select type, then you can select type here in which format you report. So I'm selecting type as bar here, and then click on next button. Here you can configure the report by setting field as group by, stack by, aggregation. Then after, click on next button. Here you can set the style for this report. Click on save button to save this report. If you want to run this report, then click on run button. If you want to share this report, then you can click on share button to share this report. This is third new functionality which is added, by which we can see report on service portal. So you have to add report wizard on service portal. Before doing this, install this plugin to enable this wizard in instance. Click on this icon, select the report here. And click on save button. This is the way we can show report on service portal. Now see fourth feature, which is interactive analysis. For this, interactive analysis plugin should be installed in the instance. This functionality is available for list of records. So I'll open incident table, right click on column, click on launch interactive analysis button. These are the reports created on incident table. You can manipulate the data by group by, stack by, or applying filter on the incident table. So here I'm selecting column. So you can see data has been managed. Now I'll talk about responsive canvas dashboard. Responsive canvas dashboard was introduced in Istanbul Relief, but in Jakarta Release, with the help of responsive canvas dashboard, we can create a dashboard version of a homepage. So click on homepage, select the homepage for which you want to create the dashboard version. So now I'm selecting ITIL homepage here. Click on gear icon. Click on create dashboard version button. If you want to add this homepage into a existing dashboard version, then you can click on this radio button. But if you want to create a new dashboard version for this homepage, so click on create new dashboard radio button and click on create button. So now a dashboard version for your ITIL homepage has been created. If you want to add a visit here, so you can click on this plus icon. Here you can select the type. So I'm selecting a report here. If you want to add this report, then click on this report and click on add button. So now this report has been added in ITIL homepage dashboard. Now this is our dashboard. You can change the size of the report you have added just now. This is the way we can change the size. If you want to share this dashboard among the users and groups, so click on this icon. Add group users and rows here. So now I'm inviting Abel Tutor. And here I'm passing the message. If you select recipient as can edit, then this user can edit this dashboard. But if you select recipient as can view, then this user is not able to edit this dashboard. So I'm selecting recipients as can edit and click on invite button to invite this user. If you want to remove this user, then click on this button to remove this user. To add a tab in this dashboard, either you can click on this icon and click on create tab, or you can click on this icon to configure this dashboard. By clicking on this, you can create a tab for this dashboard, and here you can apply the layout for the tabs. So if I want to change the layout for this, so I'm selecting here. So now the layout has been changed. I'll create a tab here. I'll give the name as testing. To add the visit, you click on this icon to add the visit. Now click on homepage. You will see a button open dashboard version is available for this homepage. Because we have created a dashboard version for ITIL homepage. So if I click on this, then we will be navigating to ITIL homepage dashboard version.